to Zandvoort. Bags are packed, cars packed, cage room is packed, and yeah, let's head on to the ferry and down to Harwich. We're just about to take the car onto the ferry, or head down to the port terminal at least. We've just been in and had the Premier Inn, which is literally just down the road from the ferry terminal. Have some food, have a little drink, and yeah, let's head on over to the ferry. Ferry's here, got our deck keys, we've got our cabin keys, and yeah, just waiting to board onto the boat now. So we're here at Zandvoort. There's a fair bit of work going on behind. They're building the grandstand as we speak. Just got the trailer all chained up, seeing as we're leaving it here, heading off into the Amsterdam for the day. Ferry crossing was actually pretty good. Managed to get a good night's sleep on the cabin, which is good. Had a nice bottle of wine and helped us obviously get off to sleep. So yeah, leave the car here for the day, head off into Amsterdam, do a bit of exploring, and then back here tomorrow morning on Saturday. We've got 5 free practice sessions, so that's going to be plenty of track time to learn it in person, which is great. And then the end of the afternoon on Saturday, we've got 2 qualifying sessions ready for the races on Sunday. But there's also a big car event on, the Maguire's Old Timers Festival. So there's all sorts going to be here. There's going to be Morgans here. We've got classic Porsches and the classic touring car race, I think, happening here. So yeah, should be a really good weekend. So yeah, let's head on out to Amsterdam. guys, welcome to Circuit Zandvoort. So, it's Saturday morning now. It's chucking it down this morning, as you'll see from a little bit of video I put in around the first practice session we had of the day. Torrential rain overnight, so it's nice and wet. Luckily, we managed to start drying the circuit out, which really helped. So it's getting to close to 10:30 now, and it's nearly dry. The back side of the circuit, which has all of the sand dunes covering it and shielding it, isn't as dry yet, obviously because of the wind's not drying it out, and the ambient temperature wasn't high enough. It's getting a bit of a clear sky now, which is good, as you can just about see over there. We're getting there. It shouldn't rain now for the next 4 hours or so, so hopefully the rest of free practice should be dry. And then we've got qualifying later on this afternoon, so hopefully it'll be dry for that as well. And the forecast for tomorrow looks okay as well for the races, so we should be okay for the next amount of time we're on track. It should be dry, which is good. Brilliant circuit, a lot of banked corners, almost like carousels on the Nürburgring, and I'm trying to remember, is it Shell Oil, I think it's called, down in Alton Park, the right hand carousel kind of corner. Quite a few of those here, which makes it really good for keeping your speed up. But it just obviously takes a little bit of time to build the confidence to be able to get more and more speed around those banked corners. As it was wet, it was obviously quite hard to do that. I think there's Porsches out at the minute, or TVRs, or let's have a look. Is it a Morgan? Oh no, it looks like a Caterham style car. Not sure what exactly. But yeah, not bad times. Managed to get, I think it was 5th or 6th fastest in FP2, which is pretty good considering it's wet. First time on the track, obviously. I've obviously tried learning it on the game, as you've probably seen in one of my other videos. But yeah, let's hope it stays dry. Race one, qualifying, I managed to get 8th on the grid. However, because it's a mixed class race, it means I'm actually 6th in class on the grid. Just too bad, I've got 2 megas around me, which they've got good pace, so hopefully if I can get an opportunistic move, try and get past them, try and keep it with a Sigmax slot, hopefully try and progress. Race two, so qualifying for that, I'm 10th on the grid, with 8th in class position on the grid. So hopefully we can try and make something out of that. The times were coming down and down. Q1, qualifying one, the lap times were around 1:59 in 2 minutes. Q2, everybody's times dropped. So I was out in the car, obviously. I saw my times coming down to 1:58, thinking, yay, obviously we're getting there. But obviously because of the temperature, the track was cooling at the time, it looked like everybody's times were improving. So yeah, we'll see what we can do, and hopefully we can make a good day of it tomorrow. Okay, so Sunday morning, race day. Rained overnight, as you can see, circuit's a little bit wet. I think we're going to stick with a dry setup. We know how it handles, and I think it is going to dry off. Probably within 5 or 6 laps, there should be a dry racing line. So take it steady for the five laps, and then hammer and tong after that. Hopefully everyone else goes with a wet setup, see what happens. But I think dry setup is the way to go. Sun is obviously coming up just over my shoulder, so I think we should be alright to stick with a dry setup. So let's see how we get on. Oh, that's race one over. Intense, exciting race. Unfortunately, I made a mistake. Probably, I think it was about halfway through the race. At the second chicane, I went in a bit too deep on the brakes, locked up the brakes, back slid around on me, and I ended up facing the wrong way on the circuit. Managed to do a little donut, get back out in front of Spencer Fortag, which meant I didn't lose any positions. However, it did mean I lost the front pack, and I was right on the back of Rick Potter, who was in sixth at the time, I think it was. So I might have caught up the front pack, but who knows. The sun's shining. Let's hope no black clouds come for the second race, and let's hope we can try and get a better finish than seventh in class this time.
Oh,
race two over. Awesome race, action packed. It was an incredible race, absolutely incredible. Loads of close battles, no damage thankfully, but there was lots of close incidents, a lot of drifting, safety car. But Sam, one of our best colleagues here in racing, he won it, a second and a first. On the grid, obviously, for the second race, managed to bring it in to finish off in sixth, so four grid positions up. Better than the first race, action-packed, plenty of calamities, dad being an idiot. Absolutely awesome race, brilliant European weekend, and yeah, nice to bring the car home nice and safe, no damage, so yeah, couldn't have hoped for more. Okay, so car's all packed up, just got to put the cover on it, and then we're heading down to the Hook of Holland so we can catch the ferry all the way back to Harwich. We've got the 10 p.m. ferry, should get us into Harwich at about, I think it's 6:30 in the morning, Monday morning. So nice sleeper ferry, makes it nice and relaxing, nice and easy, and yeah, see how we can get on.